Cool.
Yo. TGI Friday, man. Give me them TGI Friday pills. Tell you something, I am J Piss Presents. I am your life coach, and class is definitely in session. Hey, let's just put respect on the people in our lives that have great maturity. Let's just put some respect and appreciation on the people in our lives that always been solid. They never changed up. They never flipped. You just know that person for who they are. They loyal. They respectful. That's just who they are. Like, it's for the cool. Like, some people, that's just who they are. And I love it. They stick to who they are, what they know. And they never change. Some people will flip and change, but it ain't even healthy for them. It definitely ain't healthy for you, but you can see it ain't even healthy for them. But I got respect and love for people in my life that just, they just been who they are. It's a blessing. Who they are compliments them, and who they are compliments the people that they're tied to. See, the only time I want a person to change is when it's for the best. Why change something? If it ain't broke, why are you trying to fix it? Why change something that's working for you? And it's for not only the betterment of you, but it's also beneficial to the people you tied to. So, man, like, in friendships, in relationships, even with family, y'all got to be able to agree to disagree. We're not going to agree on everything. But see, what I love about people, solid people, real people, you can have an argument. You can have a disagreement. You can even fall out. But it never alters the love, the respect y'all have for one another. That's how you know you got a real relationship. That's how you know you got real family members. That's how you know you got a solid friendship. When things can go left, but it never touches the foundation. The foundation of y'all's bond. See, some of y'all don't realize God will expose what you have to prove what you have isn't real by circumstances, situations, an argument. But see, if things go left and they don't come back right, then God is questioning your bond with that person. All it took was the right situation. All it took was the right circumstance to prove what you have or what you had was not real. A lot of people are hurt and shocked at truth. You shouldn't be mad at truth, no matter how bad it looks or it feels. The truth will set you free. That's freedom to remove yourself from certain situations and reveal, understand when God is revealing an individual that's in your life. It shows you how to move different, move accordingly, responsibly. And I'm going to tell you, more people are bruised by family. But you got to come into this life or come into this level of adulthood understanding, can't nobody hurt you worse than family. Because family know you. They have instant access because of last name and blood ties. You can't choose your mama. You can't choose your daddy. You can't choose your siblings. You can't choose your grandma, your aunts, or your uncles. So the reality is, when you see people for who they are, you need to move accordingly. Everybody ain't going to always be family. All friends ain't friends. And all mates ain't true lovers. But when God reveals who they are, move accordingly. The last time somebody moved in that manner towards me, I didn't go emo. I went logical. The first thing I said to myself was, you know what? That's vital information. Now, Jeff, what are you going to do about this situation? Sometimes y'all got to be thankful when God give you truth about certain situations and about certain people. Instead of getting mad and upset all the time, just say to one needs to say to self, thank you. Okay, now what am I going to do? How am I going to move accordingly now that I know this? Now that I'm aware of who they are, aware of the situation, what's real about the situation? This is how you're going to learn and teach yourself how to move in a way where you're not wasting so much time and also disrupting yourself emotionally. When you have the ability to see something that is bad, but don't go emotional, but yet you have the willpower to go logical, to a point where you just say to yourself, that's vital information. Yeah, it's messed up. Yeah, what they did ain't right. Yeah, what they said ain't right. But it's still truth and vital information to help you move forward in life in a healthier way. Stop getting mad when God give you truth about certain situations and people. Stop getting upset. Had it occurred to you that the universe is trying to help you so you don't be easily deceived? Some of us want the truth, but then get the truth and then don't know how to handle the truth. Don't know how to move with the truth. Go emotional with the truth. You don't even move in wisdom. See, that's how you know not only are they bad, but you need to work on yourself as well. Because you can't even handle truth when God gives it to you. And sometimes truth ain't always for everybody to know. Sometimes God will give you truth for just for you to know and move accordingly. Everybody ain't got to know your business. Everybody don't got to know how you move. When it says the truth will set you free, what are you trying to be free from? Because obviously God sees something in your relationship or in that situation that's not healthy or not good for you for life going forward. I said this a while back. How God gives you truth in wisdom proves how you should move. If God reveals truth to you while you with that person, that's your opportunity to confront them. If God gives you truth by yourself, that means God wants you to make plans and preparation on your own. You ain't got to let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. You ain't got to go emotional just because you don't like what happened or like what somebody else said or done. This is your opportunity to move as an adult. It switches the game from checkers to chess. What up, Miss Cherry? I see you, Queen. I see you, Dolores. Blessings to you. I'm telling you, today going to be a beautiful day because we're going to have more self-control when God gives us truth. Some of us can't handle the truth but want the truth. You immature. I know certain people ain't right, ain't doing right, ain't living right, but what about you? You know why I'm more concerned about you? It's because you got to be with you all day. You got to be with you for the rest of your life. So forget about what they said and what they done. I'm more concerned about you. I'm concerned about how you respond. I'm concerned about how you react. I'm concerned about how you gonna move once God gives you the truth that you need. Everybody ain't for you. Everybody, you wasn't put here to be loved and accepted by everybody. Everybody is not going to agree with you. But the reality is, when it comes to us and our family, friends, and mates, after things go left, pay attention to if it goes back right. Because certain situations were designed for God to reveal so you can see people for who they are. Certain situations where people, man, yeah, you go left, you don't hear from them no more. Well, that just proved that's all the information you need to know. That wasn't really your friend. Y'all can't even have a conversation without losing each other or willing to let each other go. And some people will do you wrong and then become distant because they know they did you wrong. They don't want to hold themselves accountable for their actions. But you need some of y'all need to learn how to leave people where they at. Like the elders say, let alone. Leave people alone. Folk will jack you up. You trying to deal with them. You trying to, you compromise your spirit trying to over accept or overly help somebody that don't need no help. Folk are well aware of what they doing and how they doing it. The only person you can change and control is you. I said the only person you can change and control is you. You can't control what another grown person gonna do. Folks gonna do what they want to do regardless. I had a homegirl post yesterday about cheating. I said, well, when it comes to cheating, one who cheats out to others has already cheated themselves. And I said, know the difference when you dealing with a male or a female versus a real man and a real woman. See, a male or a female will cheat, but a real man and a real woman will simply just leave. There's a difference in maturity because of how one operates. Y'all got to know the intel and details of an individual, how they function through challenges, how they function when they test it, how they function when things go left. How they function when they feel high levels of pressure. That tells you all you need to know about people. And whether or not you should invest in them with your time, your effort, your love, your wisdom, your knowledge. Some people, man, don't deserve that access in your life. And you learn that as time go by. Access should have been denied. Some people aren't worthy of your presence. And this is not cockiness. This is just the power of acknowledgement. God said you said you wanted to win. You said you wanted love. You said you want to be happy. Some of y'all got people in your life right now and they inconveniencing you. Because what you desire and what you are praying for ain't aligned with them being in your life. God is still questioning why certain people, places, and things are in your life right now. Because it's not aligned with your blessings. It's not aligned with your prayers. It's not aligned with what you've been manifesting. These people can not only be a distraction, but they can block you and keep you from some of the best opportunities, moments in life. And you got to know that. You got to know that when you keep trying to do things and things ain't working out in your favor. You're trying to do that and things still ain't working out. You're weary. You're spiritually drained. It can be, but not only can it be you, but it could be the people you tied to. That is a hindrance to you. This is why to be grown, you got to be able to make the tough decisions. Those who love and support me, like and share. Like and share. And if I inspire you in some type of way, my Venmo or my Cash App is in the title. But I'm going to tell you something. You only got one life to live, and when it's over, it's over. But you better stop wasting time. Focus on people that don't want better. That ain't trying to do better. They still talking about the same thing you was talking about 5 years ago. Some of your homies are still doing the same thing we were doing when we were teenagers. Some of your homies or females still on that same energy y'all was on in your early 20s. They ain't growing. So how can they be of any benefit but what not to be? What not to be or what not to do? That's the only thing you can learn from some of these people. Because there is no growth. There is no change. There is no development. It ain't healthy for you. You can't even get to where you want to be by dealing with them. I'm telling you right now, if you ever need a confirmation, some of y'all need to hearken to this. Y'all got to lead people where they at. You just going to have to do it. If you want what you've been manifesting and what you've been desiring, your aspirations, your goals in life, if you truly trying to be successful, you're going to have to lead them where they at. That's some family members. That's some friends. And that's some relationships. Some mates. Leave them where they at. It ain't healthy for you. It ain't going to work for you. For where you trying to go and what you trying to do, they not aligned to the promise in your life. They not aligned to the purpose in your life. They are more of a hindrance than an asset to your situation. They chose to be over there, leave them over there. They chose to stay over there, let them stay over there. Let them stay over there. Y'all, man, I'm telling y'all, man, some of y'all will go good for a little while and then you back to your old ways. You back to dealing with certain people that ain't healthy. You back to moving which how you was moving in your past, but thinking in your future, you will have better results. And let's just address the elephant in the room. Let's just address the elephant in the room. The abundance of your heart is spoken from your mouth. The abundance was in your heart is spoken from your mouth. Y'all got to start paying attention to people's pipeline. Y'all got to pay attention to people's pipeline, meaning what they say. If you want to know about somebody, you got to be a super listener. If you want to hear how somebody truly feel, you got to pay attention and listen. Folk gonna tell you all they need, all you need to know, all you need to hear. All you got to do is ask some serious questions. Some of y'all need to ask some people in your life some serious questions, because this is vital information you need to know so you can know how to move going forward with your life. Some of y'all lacking confirmation right now, clarity right now with certain people in your life. And all God is saying, you need to ask the right questions. Come on, I'm speaking to somebody right now. Speak, God. Speak. I'm telling you right now, you need to ask some serious questions for what you're trying to do with your life and where you're trying to go in your life. The people that you are aligned and tied to right now, you need to be asking them some serious questions. And when you ask this question, be a super listener. Because I'm telling you, the abundance of the heart is proven, is revealed by what people say, by what comes out of people's mouth. Y'all need to ask serious questions with family, friends, and mates. Ask serious questions. You need to know truth. Truth leads to clarity. Clarity leads to understanding. Understanding shows you in the way which you should go. But how can you know if you're not being given truth? If you're not clear or have a clear understanding? If you don't have clarity, how can you know how to move not only with you or your life going forward, but with other people if y'all don't have an understanding? I always say with my clients, we have to communicate to a high level of understanding. That means we should not have a conversation with not having a clear understanding of what we're talking about and how we're going to move going forward. This is adulting. This is adulting at its highest form. Y'all got to start taking your life serious so folk can put some respect on your access that you give them. What's up, bro? I'm telling you right now, the reality is When it comes to your life, you got to make better choices. And how can I take you serious if you don't take you serious? How can I take you serious if you don't take you serious? You only got one life to live. I'm telling you, be conscious of how you treat you. Because how you treat you gives off energy to teach others how to treat you. So you need to take care of yourself better than what you're doing. Some of y'all need to get more rest. Some of y'all need to drink more water. Some of y'all need to practice protecting your peace and going where you're celebrated, elevated, motivated, and loved. This has to be a practice. This got to be a way of living. Otherwise, you're going to compromise your journey in life.
Okay. Where? On the TV.
Okay. You get JJ the remote?
No. I want to watch TV downstairs.
Okay. We'll get the remote. Give it to me. Where is that? Where the remote at?
It's in the TV.
Okay. Hold on, y'all. But I'm going to tell you something. We got to begin to take our life a lot more serious, because the reality is our time is very valuable. And if you're trying to accomplish the goals that you set out to accomplish, you're going to have to make conscious decisions. You're going to have to learn how to let people go and leave people where they at. Everybody ain't for you. Everybody don't have your back. Everybody not in your best interest. And you got to be aware. I'm going to tell you, self-awareness is very important. You got to be aware, because if you're not aware of your surroundings, if you're not aware of who people are in your personal life, if you're not aware of who got your back, if you're not aware of who love you, who truly support you, you will be deceived. Why would God take you up and you got a bunch of snakes tied to you? I mean, like I had to tell somebody yesterday, God ain't supporting that. Some folk be moving. You still moving the same way you moved last month. But you want this month to be better. How? It's the second day of the month and you still operating in August when we in September. September wants something new out of you if you want different results. So the reality is, man, God ain't supporting that. No procrastination, laziness, excuses. God ain't supporting that. Folk be out here snaking people, cutting more corners than a pan of cornbread. God ain't supporting that. God ain't supporting this low level of activity. I'm going to tell you, folk, there's more people out here blocking their blessing, but then be wanting to create a pity party because of their poor choices. You made them choices. You make them decisions. Ain't no sense of creating a pity party. Ain't nobody going to party with you. God ain't supporting that energy. You got to hold yourself accountable, make conscious decisions, say, you know what? I need to do better. This is my reality. I need to make better choices. I need to put myself around better people. I need to put myself around people that's doing the same thing I'm trying to do or where I'm trying to go. I need some new friends. I need new family. Maybe I need a new relationship, but I need to change something so I can get the betterment out of my life. You got to get tired for things to actually truly change, because tired equals immediate change, meaning you're going to make some immediate choices for changes. I said, you got to be able to make choices for changes. If you're not willing to make some serious choices, things ain't going to change for you. Pay attention to people's pipeline, because your mouth is connected to your heart, and your heart is connected to your mouth, just like it's connected to everything else. And out of the abundance of your heart, your mouth will speak on it. Your mouth will attest to how you feel. And folk, you need to be able to listen and hear people, not just physically, but spiritually. You need to hear the connotations of the vibes and energy that come out of somebody's boca, out of their mouth. Some of y'all need to ask some serious questions. People in your life, some serious questions. Because this is vital information, and it's going to show and prove how you should move going forward in life. Yeah, you might be disappointed. Yeah, you could be hurt, but I'd rather you be hurt for a moment than to be damaged for a lifetime, wasting time. This is your reality, and you only get one life to live. And I'll be dang if I sit here and let you waste your life all because you don't want to hear truth. You're afraid to hear truth. You don't want to know somebody else's truth about you. It's okay. But I'm going to tell you something. You know you got something real. You know you got something established. You know you got something strong when you can be honest with your mate. When you can be honest with your family. When you can be honest with your friends. When y'all can agree to disagree. When things can go left but still go right. When y'all can fall out but the love never changes. See, if your love changed because of a circumstance, God is questioning your relationship. Come on, speak, God. Speak. God said, I don't care who they are. The love should never change. When it comes to trials, tribulations, circumstances, if the love changes, God is exposing your bond. What you have, it ain't real. It ain't established. It ain't strong. All it took was the right situation to reveal and discover who that person really is to you. Some of y'all gonna find out that they're nothing. Because the reality is, the circumstance exposed it. The love should not change just because of a disagreement or a fallout or some few circumstances. If the love changes, then they never loved you from the start, because that love is set up on conditions, condio, or more or less filio, but it's not agape. It's not established. It's not true. I'm going to tell you, to be honest, some people, man, I love them in a way, whereas when we fell out, it made me love them more. Because when we fell out, or we had a disagreement, we came back stronger. I miss you, yo. I miss you too. No, I love you. I love you too. Yo, I got your back. Yeah, I got your back too. The love come back. The love is actually stronger. Y'all got to pay attention to these signs. If you fall out or have a disagreement with somebody and it dismantles or breaks up the relationship and y'all don't come back, y'all don't reconcile, then all God has said, you know what? Leave that where that's at. Because obviously that relationship wasn't real. That bond wasn't truly established. And you got to see people for who they are and see situations for what it is. I always say at the end of my lives, hey, look here, man, you ain't on my line for me. Nobody put a gun to your head. I hope what I've said have blessed you in some type of way, inspired you in some type of way. I always say at the end of my lives, peace and love. A man functions off peace, a woman functions off love. If you don't respect peace and love by now, that's why you're losing. Because if you take a man's peace, he's going to look for peace in some other person, place, or thing. If you play with a woman's love, she's going to seek love in some other person, place, or thing. This is your reality. You're going to pay the stupid tax of life because y'all don't respect how God moves. Anything God sent should be well appreciated. But if it's not appreciated, the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. And this is how you pay the stupid tax of life. You pay the stupid tax of life by literally have to learn a lesson by losing something. Why do we have to see the realize the value in something after it's gone or after it's on the outside of your life? It's because you lack maturity. It's because you won't grow up. It's because you won't hold yourself accountable of your actions. It's because you be tripping and slipping, losing grips on life. You don't take your life serious. It's a new month. How you start it is how you'll finish it. Some of y'all need September to be better than August. But it can't get better if you're doing the same thing. It can't get better if you're not making better choices and better decisions. I need you to start making better choices. And I'm telling you, don't pay the stupid tax of life all because you're not mature or you acting a fool. Because I'm telling you, God will bring you to the front of the congregation of that good man that was godly sent or that good woman that was godly sent. And you have to witness that good man and that good woman being witnessed, being loved, being peaceful, being successful, being happy with somebody else. Some of y'all are witnessing people walk around with your blessing, whether it's people, places, or things, all because of your ways. The iniquity that's in you, the issues that's in you, the problems that's in you. Focus on you, because more than anybody outside of you, you got to live with you for the rest of your life. You're going to be with you for the rest of your life. You're going to die with you. There's one person you're going to be with all day. Folk going to come in and out your day, in and out your life. There's one person you're going to be with all day, and that person is you. Work on you. Make sure you good. My brother called me about a situation yesterday. I said, hey, look here, brother. Protect your peace. Protect your peace at all costs. I know what they say. I know what they do. But hey, guess what, brother? You got to be with you all day. And you got certain things you got to handle. So the reality is you better protect your peace and your energy at all costs. I said, do that, do it. I need you to be militant with this. I said, regardless of what they say and what they do, it do not matter. You better make sure you good. Choose you first and you'll have a blessed day. He called me back last night. He said, thank you, bro. I just want to let you know, thank you. Because the reality is, y'all ain't considering self, but y'all think about everybody else. But everybody else ain't think about you. Everybody else ain't think about you. That ain't selfish. That's responsible. Take care of yourself. You only have one life to live. Bless you, Pop. I see you. Bless all my family in the ATL. I'm telling y'all, you got one life to live. Please don't waste it. Please don't waste your time. I know you done had setbacks. I know you done, people done switched up on you. I know you done felt heartache and pain. I know you done felt levels of no's and denials. I know things didn't work out the way you planned. It's okay. Today is a new day. It's a new month. I'm telling you, make some conscious decisions, some better choices, protect your energy, better your health. I'm telling you, move different and change your circle or your atmosphere. You can be, go be around some new people. Some of y'all, to become better, you need to be around better people, places, and things. Change up your regiment, how you operate. And I'm telling you, September will be better than August. I can guarantee you that. September will be better than August. I can guarantee you that if you make some different choices, if you just love on you just a little bit more, I'm telling you, you're going to bless your month. So I love y'all, man. I pray that y'all make better choices today. I pray that you capitalize off this new 24. Somebody didn't get today, but you did. What you gonna do with it? How much have you smiled this week thus far? Have you even smiled today? It only takes a second. It only takes one bone to smile. to complement your exterior and your interior design. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. Listen. Y'all need to listen. But you also need to ask serious questions. Things that's going to complement your life with clarity, communication, understanding, where you can move in a healthier way. Ask some serious questions with the people you got in your life. Because as long as you're clear and you have a clear understanding, you can move in a healthier way. You can make better decisions, better choices. Because some people you got to learn how to love from a distance. Some people you got to love them from a distance. You love them, but they just got to be distant. It got to be a space between you and them. So you can move better. So you can make better choices. So you can be more healthy. Do this. Do this and see what results you get. I am Jay Pitts Presents. I am your life coach. And class is dismissed. Let's go, baby. You got one life to live. Please don't waste it. It ain't even worth it. This is for the cool. Please don't waste it. Don't waste it. Respect a mature individual. We can agree to disagree. We can agree, but I still love you.
This is
God. A mature individual. Love don't never change. It will remain solid. Yeah. Gotta respect. You gotta respect true people that love right. That can remain. Gotta respect them. There are people that remain solid. They love don't change. Their respect for you don't change. You got to respect it. Because everybody don't move like that. I am Jay Pitch Presents. I am your life coach. And class is dismissed. Time is of the essence. And it starts what? Right now. Make a decision. I need you to make some decisions today that's going to make the future you look back at the you of you today and say, thank you. Thank you. Bless your life. What better choices? Because with better choices, create better changes. Love y'all, man. Y'all go and be blessed.